The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the International Championship!
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure.
To the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us.
The hits keep coming, Jason Sensation, and just in case you were wondering if the moment was lost on C-Note, he is summoning the spirit of Katie Angelo in order to bring his best to his first singles title opportunity in OCW Fed. We got to know the families watching. Who do you got, boss?
I don't know. C-Note is an X-Factor in this match. He is an unknown, if you will, on the big stage. We've had rookies, you know, promotions hitting the big stage for Road to Glory. This is going to be one of C-Note's biggest tests to date, if not his biggest test, taking on a former CCW World Champion, former Light Heavyweight Champion, and current International Champion, the one and only Tony Two Touch, the New Deal. Tony Evans, dude.
Yeah. And it's like, yo. Boys, do you hope to offend on I am not really pushing on this picture by Sam?
Jason Sensation, they say real men wear pink. The Tarantula, Mr. CCW, the New Deal, Tony Touch, Antonio Everett, call him what you want. For the last 3 years, you have had to call him one of OCW's best. You've said it multiple times here, boss. These aren't new stars. These are the top of the top, the cream of the crop. And Antonio Everett could very well be the best of the best here tonight.
Modern era. Top competitors in OCW. We finally made it, Jacob. Now we actually have current stars. They're not even new. They're current. I love hammering that factoid home. Look at Kareem. A little trepidation in his face after, Turmo 297.
The announcement. Yeah, Kareem Franklin, all of the cowardice over the last few weeks, especially directed at Claudio Stardom. He will be locked inside a steel cage next Friday on Turmoil. But we've got business to handle before that. Claudio is after that very championship he felt he never got a fair chance to defend against Antonio Everett after being betrayed by Kareem. Antonio Everett right now has no small task ahead of him, though, boss. C-Note has been on a roll this season and last.
And he won a triple threat against Nate Mack and Sheldon Tremblay, who is missing. We miss you, Sheldon. Kidnapped by Cassidy. It's like kidnapping season, but yes, he's the number one contender. Biggest match of his career coming down right now in the National Championship. Benjamin C-Note Franklin versus Antonio Everett. Can't wait.
Introducing the challenger from Harlem, New York. Weighing in at 240 pounds, Benjamin Franklin. And his opponent from London, England, weighing in at 263 pounds. He is the International Champion, Antonio Everett.
Oh, not a mixed reaction from the crowd, J-Con. Never thought I'd hear that. That's crazy. It's crazy.
It's true. But you saw how betrayed they were. They wanted Antonio Everett to defeat Claudio, but not the way he did as the New Deal. I also had a chance to sit down with Meg during the break. She's a lovely woman. Megan, throw that shit up!
Yay!
Fix your eye, Megan. We'll pay for it. It's fine. We got good insurance here.
International Championship on the line. Boss, Road to Glory continues. Banger after banger. Greg, ring the bell. And Tony, whoa. He likes to utilize that clothesline, that lariat. Came up just a little bit short there, and I think Benjamin C-Note Franklin is lucky that he did. And now he's able to counter, big gut kick, using those legs, those strong legs, and eventually takes down the tarantula with a chop block.
It's going to be interesting. Like, you know, C-Note's never fought Tony Everett. Tony Everett's never fought C-Note. It's going to be interesting to see if he can acclimate to this former rookie, now current wrestler style. Right now he's having a little bit of trouble. Just got dropped on his head by the newly minted wrestler.
That's a very good point now. And another innovative offensive maneuver there from C-Note. And Tony Everett clearly not ready for it. Tony is usually the guy who has fought his opponents many a times over his illustrious career. C-Note, not one of those guys, to your point here, and it's showing in the early going that he's not ready for what the representative of the family is bringing down. Very impressive performance in that aforementioned triple threat match last week, boss. So C-Note has definitely earned this opportunity.
Definitely. And right now, it looks like the family might be paying dividends for C-Note right now. The dark horse in this match, most definitely.
Jesus.
Nice counter.
Pile driver there from Antonio Everett. C-Note able to get back to his feet quickly, which is a good thing. A pin attempt there may have done it. C-Note wants to try and slow the pace down so he can recover. It's not going to happen. Antonio Everett not going to let you slow it down. And he drops him on his head again.
Jesus. The worst thing Antonio could do is look past his current opponent, C-Note, and look towards resolution. Because just like that, Claudio, you know, it happened to Claudio, it could happen to Tony. Happenstance is a mug in OCW, Hoot. What's to say? 90% what happens to you, 10% how you react, or the other way around, Jake Allen? You tell me.
Definitely the other way around. Woo! 10% what happens to you, 90% how you react to it. Antonio Everett has made a career out of reacting the right way. And I love your point that you made there, boss. We have seen it just tonight. That's why Road to Glory is so special on the lead up to Resolution, because you never know who's walking into the grandest show with the gold. Certainly don't know right now. C-Note tried to catch the champion, but he's too savvy and he caught him with a lariat.
Oh, that's an experience from C-Note.
No doubt about it.
That is the
Antonio Everett going right after the knees there, and he likes to utilize the knees on offense, and he's doing it defensively right now. Dim mock
on Benjamin C-Note Franklin.
No cover there from Antonio Everett. This is the new deal right here. This is why Antonio Everett garnering mixed reactions, showing off, being big-headed, grandstanding, and hot-dogging instead of going for the cover like he usually would. I'm not one to question the tarantula right now. He's putting a beat down on C-Note.
You know what? I think he wants to send the message. C-Note came in hot. Sometimes you got to let these new stars know who the boss is, and that's what Tony might be doing. Oh,
Jesus Christ.
What in the world? A destroyer from Benjamin C-Note Franklin. Antonio Everett, just as C-Note did on his pile driver, quickly reacting to it. Doesn't want to get caught with his pants down.
Jesus.
C-Note, heavy strike, putting Antonio on the ropes, and now this is where a lot of damage can be done, Jason Sensation. If you are not just joining us, you don't need me to tell you that! The outside, a very dangerous place, especially in a singles championship match. Antonio Everett right now using it to his advantage and more.
And speaking of advantage, take this advantage and take this opportunity, if you're not, to follow us on twitch.tv/OCWFed. Enjoy the show, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube page, youtube.com/OCWFedTV as well. You'll be thankful you did.
You want to see more unbelievable signs of athleticism like we just saw there from Antonio Everett. That step-up stomp. Could be looking for the end right now. Oh, the waist lock, and C-Note was ready for it. He's done his homework. You can say a lot of things about the family, but they're always prepared. What in the world? More innovative offense. Indy-rific, I dare to say.
Very.
Benjamin C-Note, frankly.
Very Indy-rific.
He did drop the tarantula on his head. And got caught there. Damn mock!
Oh, my God. We might just see a new international champion. If C-Note keeps, one eye open, but right now he might get his eye shut.
Oh!
Oh, and that is your Ma's favorite knee and mine. Immediately after the dim mock, Antonio Everett doesn't wear knee pads, and it's not because he's unsafe. It's because he wants to do the maximum amount of damage to the jaws of his opponents. The cover after your Ma's favorite knee. And a huge kick out there from C-Note, not going to allow it to take him in the early going.
You know, I think taking that amount of time to drag C-Note to the appropriate angle for a pin may have given C-Note just enough time to recuperate his emotional damage.
Oh, C-Note there trying to grab the wrist to make something happen. It didn't work, but he was able to follow up. Fisherman Buster now trying to sneak out the victory. No, the New Deal. And that's the first time that I think the tarantula's been caught on his back foot for quite some time, boss.
Oh, my big headbutt. Jesus. Wait a minute.
Maybe looking for something to put this thing away.
Got his
C-Note
hands up.
Ran out of gas there. Is he part of the family or Scumchester? Oh, my God. C-Note again. That high angle teardrop back suplex. Smart move, though, to get out of the ring. Obviously, even with champion's advantage, he cannot be pinned out there.
No,
he
can't.
He's take this opportunity to counter Antonio Everett. Oh.
Inside out. Inside out. Now it might be the advantage for Benjamin Cino Frank, but he's taking a little too long. Once again, going for the same well. It's like the third time he's hit that. It's been effective. He's trying to think of something right now.
You know, Antonio Everett, I think, had an opportunity to put this thing away earlier and opted not to try it. You got to hope for the New Deal, if you're a fan of his, that this doesn't backfire on him. And it may do just that. Another DDT-like maneuver from Benjamin C-Note Franklin, trying to make a name for himself. And what a stage it would be to
trying
walk
really
into
hard.
Resolution as the new champion. Oh. Don't call it a collide. Oh, no. Antonio Everett caught him.
Oh, he didn't see that coming. He definitely did not see that one coming, Jake Allen.
Everett now right back to his feet, midsection. Oh, look at this. Spin out Fisherman Driver. These two guys loving to hook the legs, maybe trying to take away
some of
the weapons
from
each person. Oh, and we've seen this from Antonio before.
This is not a good idea. I don't think so.
450 splash. He only breaks it out when he feels threatened, boss. So that arrogance from Antonio Everett earlier clearly starting to turn to desperation. C-Note maybe looking for the payday. Everett catches him with a lariat. Looking for two. He got two. The kick doesn't connect in the leg sweep. Antonio Everett is fired up.
I think Cena's looking for an opportunity to hit some, to hit that maneuver, but he's taking too long. I'm sorry, not Antonio Everett, but Cena.
Oh, my God. Dim mock. Antonio Everett flustered a bit there at the end. Not flustered anymore. That's the White Hart lock. The White Hart special, and C-Note has no choice but to tap out. A game effort from the first-time challenger, but they don't call him Tony Top Guy for nothing. A huge retention from the international champion, Tony Everett.
C-Note had a shot, but he didn't take it. He wanted to wait for the perfect opportunity, but when you fight someone like Tony, you make the opportunity. You don't wait for the opportunity because he will take it from you. Very hard for a victory for Tony Everett. I think he's surprised by C-Note. I'm surprised by C-Note. I'm sure everybody watching on Twitch.tv and on YouTube, if you nasty, I'm also surprised by C-Note's performance as well. Bright things in the kid's future, if I do say so myself, and I do, Jake Allen.
Took a lot of kicks to the head to fell the man, and we have got more kicks to the head coming up, I am sure. Up next, the OCW World Heavyweight Championship, Mark Reese and Russ Cole. Stay with us.
Oh, yeah.